Before Windows 10, adding a user was really easy. You went into settings, you typed in a name and a few permissions, and you were done. But not anymore. Windows 10 wants to know who you are so it can track you and make suggestions and sell you stuff. Luckily, you still have some control and a few choices, and I'm going to walk you through what to expect. So I'm going to assume you're an admin on this computer like I am. Hit the Windows button, go to Settings, Accounts, and hit Family and Other Users. So here's the difference between your family and other users. If you add a family member, you're adding either an adult or a child, and the adults can have control over the children's accounts. If you're adding another user, that's if you, say, have a friend who wants to use your PC, and so you don't want to give them a lot of access to other stuff, but you want them to be able to use it. In this case, we're going to add an adult family member. So you hit Add a Family Member, and you choose to add an adult. And now you will want to enter their email address. Now this email address has to be linked to a Microsoft account. It just can't be some random thing. So I'm going to add that. I'm going to add my buddy Gordon. Hit Next. You have to confirm. And they're going to send Gordon an invitation to join my family. Now, even though Gordon hasn't seen this invitation yet, he's listed on my account here, and I can change the account type, say that Gordon's a standard user by default. Do I trust him enough to be an administrator? That's something you need to think about. I'm going to keep him as a standard user. And also, if Gordon isn't playing nicely on the PC, I could block him. You got any other Windows 10 questions? Email us at answer@pcworld.com.